So it's August 26th, I believe it is, 2022. And I wanted to just make some notes about this year. It's been terrible. We haven't had we've had no rain basically since May, other than a couple of just scattered showers. So my whole garden just stayed alive on what I watered it with. Might have did a video about this before, but I wanted to note this loofah plant. I planted this loofah plant along this new fence line that I built this spring. And there's the base of it right there. And so you can see it, you know, it's got tendrils and it goes along the, it's actually kind of overgrown, but it's heat tolerant. So, you know, it's got, we've been in the hundreds, you know, for months. And this thing has lived through it while all my other stuff died. I mean, after June, it was. And so I made a video before talking about how this plant, these loofah plants grow up this tree. This is one plant, by the way. There's not more, there's only one plant here. And I've picked a big loofah off of it earlier. It's nice. It's a tool we're gonna use in the bathroom. And I've talked about how it grew up the tree, but I wanna show you now. This thing is at the very top of the canopy, if you look up there. It goes all the way up to the top of the canopy, and there actually is a loofah. You can see there's a loofah right in the center of the screen right now. It's a fairly good size one. It wasn't as big as the other one that I grew. But anyway, I want to go around this tree too and show you the other side that's flowering. Hopefully you'll be able to get a good view of it. Let me zoom back out from here. Yeah, there's, well, I don't know how well the camera's picking this up, but anyway, the reason I grow these basically is because of that. In the middle of August, middle of July, when it's 100 and something degrees out, you have flowers, and in the morning there's bees on them, and it's a nice little thing. So anyway, that's the story about the loofah. Now there's one couple sunflowers in that picture too. Thanks for watching.